7 o'clock, according to the bells.
Awesome.
Continued RDA 2015-15, 239, 243 Main Street, Curtis.
Correct.
And I assume that's you.
Mr. Curtis is
signing in. Okay. Take your time. We did get an updated progress of work plan that you submitted through your contractor, or after speaking with contractors. Maybe you can fill us in.
Kind of like all of the above.
Okay.
I don't have to tell you, this is the busiest time of year for contractors.
Yeah.
They don't want to talk to you. They don't want to give estimates. They just want to
do the job.
Okay, so it's one of these, if you want the work done, just say so. If you don't, you know, catch me in November and I'll give you a call then. But I was able to talk to several three contractors. I get two to come by the site to take a look at it and offer what they would. And then in conjunction with what they offered and what we're expecting or wish to do, that's where these specifications basically came from.
Mm-hmm.
And I think it's pretty much in line with, like I say, what the basic principle is rehabbing that existing location to put in a concrete pad, fence it in, and give an obstructed view for vision, according to what we're working with the Board of Health.
Mm-hmm.
Joanne? Because she's, I guess, looked at that location before and said, you know, you guys got to get a gate on the front of it and get the obstructed view. That was, you know, that impetus plus the fact that the thing's been
mm-hmm.
in not good shape for a while was the impetus.
So I did review the plan that was submitted, plan in words, pretty thoroughly. And I actually made a site visit today, if you guys can believe that. It's pretty clear to me. It seems like a pretty well drawn out plan. The thing I did notice when I was at the site was the entire parking lot slopes to the back of the property, or where the wetlands are, which makes sense. So I don't know if you've given any thought to, or if you had any plans for how the stormwater runoff, when you're going to redirect the pitch of the pad back towards the parking lot, and I don't recall. Are you going to have some sort of something like a trench drain to intercept, or is it just going to flow to where it's flowing now? What was the
plan? Pretty much where it's flowing now, as far as I know. Now, that place has been there since the early 60s.
Sure.
And the parking lot, the gradual slope of the parking lot tends to drain into the lawn area that we have.
Sure.
Down towards the dumpster end, there's still enough lawn area where there is parking spaces.
Mm-hmm.
Intercept that water, so we didn't realize we might have a problem with that.
I don't necessarily think it's a problem. I just wanted to know what your plans were with that.
We had even considered curbing at one time because people tend to pull up on the grass on the front row, and that would interfere too desperately with the plows, which we have a wonderful plow driver. I have no idea how they could do that, but that would interfere with the plowing.
Sure.
The curb would.
The curb would.
You're probably better off the way it is now, letting the water sheet off.
Well, like I said, it seems to be buffered by that lawn expanse that we have at the end of the driveway.
Now, the one question I had about the plan was the bollards. Are they going behind the bollards mentioned in the plan? Are they going behind the dumpster to stop the dumpster from pushing into the curb? Okay, that's what I thought.
Just inside the rear curbing and offset in. As you're looking at it, facing it, they would be to the left side of that area, because to the right side is where we're putting the recycled containers, six of the recycled for plastic, paper, and so forth. So at some point, we know JRM's going to do the continuous stream, or whatever they call it, totally
put everything in one bin and
one container type of thing, but in the interim, because when they say in the near future, we don't know.
Yeah.
So we have a gate there for access for people to go into the barrels, and then the other side is just the entryway for the JRM to come in, and the bollards are back there to just respect
They've damaged our enclosure numerous times.
Mm-hmm.
Because they just back the truck up against the dumpster and push it till it's in about right.
Yeah, the curb won't hold it, but those bollards will.
Right.
And the way I understand the plan, what the contractor did or is going to do is a monolithic pour, which means they're going to pour the wall as well as the slab in one continuous pour, and then leave rebar sticking up so you can put, for instance, a cinder block style curb around.
Correct.
Topped off with cement concrete.
Yes.
Which seems like a reasonable
curb just around the pad.
Just around
the
pad.
Dumpster.
And the pad is going to be pitched back towards the parking lot, so it's not going to flow off the back. It'll flow to the
curb
front.
The curb will be on the sides and the rear of the
right.
The pad.
Yeah.
Where
it's water and debris containment as well.
So what they
number
where
two
is that?
Or number eight in the.
They talk about the designated pad area. They call it sledge pour, and I call it a monolithic pour, to create exterior walls to be required height for grade pitch, and then vertical rebar, 8-inch spacing.
So exterior walls around entire pad.
Referring to the walls that go down from the pad, not up from the pad.
Okay.
That's what it's referring to.
So going back to the question, will be. To form, but there is some effort here to form some perimeter curb.
There's going to be a curb, correct, as well.
So
this part is talking about the walls that go down. Yeah.
Do we have some, do we know what that's going to look like, that curbing? Do we have, is it a minimum 3-inch?
Well, it sounds to me like if they're going to put cinder blocks, then it would be an 8-inch. It would be a minimum 8-inch.
Cement block.
They could put, I'm just trying to think of hollow core blocks that they would fit over the rebar and then fill the cores. I think that's probably what they're going to do.
Wouldn't it have to be more than 8 inches in the back where it's, they're trying to pitch it forward?
This is independent. This curb is going on top of the slab after the slab is poured. So the wall in the back, from what I understand, is going to be poured with the slab.
Oh, okay, so the wall has got some height.
Exactly. And I did look at that in the back. It does pitch away. It doesn't pitch away very much. But being that it's pitched from the front to the back now, and then you're going to kind of reverse it. So that there might be 18 inches in some areas there that you would have to, because the timber retaining wall is coming out too.
Right.
So maybe 18 inches to 24 inches height.
I guess my question is, now everything that I saw is pitching back towards, away from Route 28 towards the that grassed area.
Yeah, that's what I saw.
The back of the parking area. Now you're pitching your area where the dumpster is this way.
Back toward the parking
area. Mm-hmm.
Correct. Now this area, where is the runoff from that impervious? Is it just going to bleed out to the side?
That's basically it. And again, it, as it comes around the side away from the fencing, is buffered by the lawn area. And on the opposite side, we have there is a curb there and existing exit driveway fence. It'd probably drain a little go around that end of the dumpster pad. It doesn't seem to be that much, but it would be draining basically the way it is now.
I guess my question is, in the winter, would that, form any kind of ice buildup? That would be.
Are you talking about within the dumpster enclosure itself?
I wouldn't care about the dumpster enclosure.
In the little valley that's created.
Yeah.
Would a little gravel strip to the right and left of the.
We've never had anything like that. I've been there 19 years.
Yeah, but everything is pitched this way. Now you're pitching it a little bit this way. So it's got to flow back towards that end of the parking lot.
Well, the likelihood of icing there, I'd be guessing. Idea how much icing that might be.
As long as it's pitched in the right direction.
Is this dumpster
sufficiently
going to be roofed? No. This enclosure going to be roofed? No.
No.
The dumpster's got a lid on it.
Yeah, the dumpster has a lid.
Mm-hmm. Becky, we had that issue down there by Bagel World, you know, where model construction is, and the roof drained to the parking lot, and the problem was ice, but the problem only happened with the stream next door backed up. Here, I don't think we have that problem, so I think what will happen is if it's cold enough to ice, the snow's going to melt, so you're not going to get water runoff. And if it is warm enough, hopefully much of the water will just continue to run off.
And that's
only when it backs up from somewhere else where you get the real ice problem. Like down at West Street by the Archstone development, we get ice under the 9300 pass.
And this is not, there is no concentration of flow here.
There's no drainage area.
This parking lot is level and pitched evenly to the back, so I would assume that there's very little concentration of flow.
You never get flooding in the parking lot.
No, that
would be the issue.
So I think that, you know, just that small area is probably not going to, you know, it's not like
that. Even when we've had 10, 15 feet of snow pile on that lawn, which was recently.
It's about a few months ago, yeah.
Yeah, and it didn't melt off quickly. But we never even had any backflow from that pile of snow as a model. The ground seemed to handle everything.
Well, I'm satisfied.
Yeah, I just
with the
well, I appreciate
scope of work submitted.
I appreciate the additional detail. And I made a note of what you said, Brian, about the cement block being a minimum of 8 inches. I think containing the runoff within that concrete slab area and rerouting it to a place where it can get at least some amount of treatment, even if it's infiltration through the ground before it gets to the wetland, I think is a benefit.
There are no other questions.
No, I had a couple questions.
Oh.
I was looking through this, and I didn't see the total dimensions of the slab area. Did I miss that? So it's 10 by 15. The existing one right now is 8 by 10.
Is it in the original?
Yes.
It's in there somewhere?
I thought we had it in the original.
I looked through the original, too, but that could be wrong.
Within the existing area footprint is what you said in the original submittal. So
right where the dump, the old enclosure is right now, that's exactly where we're going to have the chain link fence on the new enclosure.
So there's not going to be any expansion.
We cannot go to the right any further because we have this much distance from the fence to a visitor parking space. And on the opposite side, we have a property line. We can't go any further that way, and we're not going to go back any further than there's 2x4, or there's beams that are there. So it's going to be exactly in the same footprint.
Whatever the exact dimension that is.
Yeah.
Well, they actually say here, they say the existing asphalt to be cut cleanly to a 12-inch line outside the new enclosure footprint. That was exactly saying. I thought I was going to say the existing.
Well, can I get that measurement when you... I can just add it to the determination.
So much.
It's 12-inch line on front and parking lot sides. So they kind of overcut the asphalt.
12 inches.
Right. The preparation.
The only other thing was it sounds like there's a lot of digging going on with this. This type of order doesn't really get into that too much. So do you guys want to condition where the material they're pulling out of there goes? It does have erosion control, whether they're taking it off-site or...
The new plan says that the excavation will be disposed of off-site properly.
Including including the asphalt.
Asphalt and existing dirt to be removed from area designated for new concrete slab and dispose of off-site property. Number four.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So it's kind of like, my vision of this is it's kind of like doing a foundation.
You're going to need some backfill left to...
We're going to excavate around, we're going to put some forms in, make this thing up.
Okay.
And the bollards...
Once you pull the forms, you got to backfill a little bit.
Yeah.
And I guess with that in mind, does this cover, you know, if there's going to be excavation? You know, I think we're all somewhat on the same page of what's going to occur, but is this, the RDA going to cover what the work that's being done, assuming that there's... you know, a negative, or I guess I see excavation work, I see requirement for erosion control.
Mm-hmm.
It's proximity to the wetland. You know, I don't see an issue necessarily with the plan, but for where we're...
Yeah, we can put those restrictions in the RDA.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Definitely.
Right. I think they need to go in.
Yeah.
I think the way it's written now, I'd like to tighten up some of this where they'd have to approach the construction from the front, from the parking lot, reach in,
right.
No machinery in the wetlands,
yeah,
things like that. So
yeah.
I made a few notes. I don't know if you guys have anything else after
so
hearing this.
So they would have
this.
Silt fence installed or something?
This definitely had silt fence installed. And just...
Compost filter tubes or... I don't know how close the wetland area is. I'm not a plant biologist.
That was pretty much right
at pretty
the
close
there,
right?
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, you said somebody said less than 10 feet.
I did the same. I drove by it to. Yeah.
So then compost filter tubes at a minimum thing. Straw wattles might be a little too light for that in that area. What do you think, Charlie?
Yeah, those straw wattles, not for this. When we're digging, we're not going to be doing straw wattles.
Right,
that would
right.
be something more out on the lawn somewhere, just a demarcation line. All right, that's fine.
All right, so that being the case, I'll entertain a motion for a negative determination with the changes we discussed.
So moved.
Second?
Second.
All those in favor? All set.
I prepared the determination. I just left a space for the dimensions of the dumpster enclosure, so I can fill that in when I get them and send it out.
All right. All right. Thank you.
Thank you.
You're welcome. We're also sending copies of everything to the Board of Health in case Joan might have any inputs she's going to give us.
Everything you received went to the Board of Health.
Great.
Okay. Great.
And.
So this doesn't allow you to proceed until you get their approval.
Mm-hmm.
So I was talking to Joan. They said they didn't review this yet, although they had input from you.
All right, so she'll make contact with us.
Yeah.
Okay. You're clear of conservation, but not necessarily clear to start construction.
Right. Yeah. Okay, we'll make sure when we can get the good-to-go signal from the entities involved.
Okay,
thank you very much.
Good luck.
Thank you.
Thanks again.
Thank you.
So we have a scheduled minor plan change for the order of conditions 270-0622, 181 South Street, Wise.
We have to be on the town guest Wi-Fi. They use this.
I happens sometimes, so I might have to pass my iPad around to show you what I'm doing.
We do have these drawings here.
Yep.
You do have those ones.
Okay.
Good, I have a few other things to show you, then for that we can minimize the passing. So, thank you for hearing me again. I believe I came before the board back in, I would say, February of 2014. It's been a long, strange trip for me, in the process of trying to put an accessory apartment in my house for my in-laws. At that point in time, you approved what you, I believe you have two pictures of plot plans.
Yes.
One is the one marked February 12, 2014. That is the one that you approved. And if you look at that one in particular.
Hold on, let me catch up with you.
Sure, Mr. Monk.
Okay.
If you look at that one in particular on the, from the front of the house, the front right of the triangle of the house, there is a driveway that's going up the side that's a newly proposed driveway. You all approved that plan. What I'm here to do is, as part of a settlement of an appeal in the zoning board, I'm here to propose a change to that plan such that I change the way my garage and driveway work in the main area where it currently is, and I give up that second driveway. So we're going to remove the impervious part of that second driveway, but we're going to add other impervious part to accommodate the parking to align with the requirement to hopefully settle the appeal that's against the zoning board and myself.
So the driveway that you're talking about eliminating is on the west side, or the left side of the plan.
It's
so this one over here.
This one
yes,
right here?
That one there, exactly.
Sorry. That driveway right there is getting eliminated.
Okay.
This driveway is getting moved over to the side.
Yeah, right. Expanded a little bit, yes. So in that process of doing that, we'll end up saving one very large tree, which is part of the contention, frankly, and about 12 bushes that are along that line that you can see crossed out as part of that initial plan.
Mm-hmm.
Unfortunately, on the other side, as a result of the change, we're going to end up losing about 5 trees. So it's a give and take in that process. And you can see those crossed out where the new driveway shows up. Okay.
Do you know approximately what size those trees are?
Those are large evergreen trees.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Do you know if they're pine trees? How big around are they approximately?
How big around? Probably about that much. They have a bunch of vines growing up amongst them and whatnot there. Some of them are in better health than others, but they're there and they're stable. I have the old submission, so it might have the type of tree, but I'm not a horticulturalist or anybody to tell you exactly what it is. There's one or two other trees that aren't pine trees that are in that space area that are going down as well, potentially, if you approve the proposed plan. So what I'm doing in particular and specific is the garage that I had proposed that you had agreed to, and frankly that the zoning board had agreed to, and CPDC agreed to, and the Board of Selectmen agreed to, and engineering agreed to, was going to be a two-car garage in the existing driveway as is. It was going to knock down the one car and it was going to be a two-car. In order to accommodate the change, the fact that I won't have the parking on this side that I'm giving up, I'm going to rotate that garage 90 degrees and make it a three-car garage. And to do that, based upon the feedback from my survey person, I have to bring the driveway out and around in order to be able to get in there. And that's where the difference in the impervious comes from.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Mr. Chairman, if I'm reading this plan correctly, and I'm probably not, all the changes he's talking about are outside the 100-foot buffer.
They are.
Just about.
So I'm not
sure. There's one minor addition, one minor thing I should make sure you're clear on that front.
Okay.
There will be 29 square feet of impervious land just barely inside the 100-foot buffer.
So
with the new driveway.
Yeah,
the new driveway.
And you're
right,
this is riverfront.
This is
too.
River,
though.
So.
Yeah, because that's the 200-foot.
Yes. So that is the change that we're suggesting.
What river is that?
It's not even, I mean, it's hard to say it's a river. Are you familiar with Sturgis Park? The Sturgis Park area?
Right.
That little tiny stream slash river that kind of goes through the back of Sturgis Park and goes back up behind my lot and my neighbor's lot and a bunch of other lots that eventually ends in a vernal pool way back there.
Well, somebody help me out here.
It's not a river.
Sturgis Park, didn't George determine that it was not a river?
Depending on what side of the street he's on, yeah, that's correct. So are you on the Sturgis?
I'm on the highway side, opposite from Sturgis.
So you, all right, so he's on the downstream side. Where it is a river.
Yeah, but he's near Walnut Street, so he's closer to Quantum Powell Players.
Wrong side. So if you were to drive down Main Street going up from here, and you take a right on Summer, and then of that first immediate left, and then the left on Hopkins, that's where Quantum Powell is. You have to go down Walnut, take a right down there, go past Curtis, go past where South merges back in, and it becomes South for a very period of,
yes,
short period of time. That's where Sturgis is. I'm right at the corner where South and Walnut become Walnut again and South. So I'm right at that corner where Walnut and South.
Gotcha.
So it might or might not be riverfront. We don't know for sure.
Okay, so you're diagonal from Sturgis.
I'm diagonal from Sturgis, yes.
So you look out your house, it's over to the right.
Correct. If I look out my house, it's over to the right. The play, the new playground, I'll put it over there.
How far are you from Sturgis?
I'm not directly across, but I'm one house up and across.
See, it could or could not be riverfront. We don't know for sure.
So this is the river that comes from the culvert that George was thinking of rehabbing.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so this is the outlet side of that.
Right.
Right.
It's the outlet of Sturgis.
Right.
Headed towards Hoover.
Yes.
Yeah.
Towards Wilbur.
Yeah.
Exactly. It goes right underneath the highway or whatever. I'm not sure where it ends necessarily.
Yeah. Yep.
Depending on what time of season you go back there, it's wet or not wet.
Yeah.
One of those type of areas. Yes, sir.
I'm wondering that I lost my memory on this if I ever had one, but why was this a notice of intent?
It was a notice of intent.
Why do we require a notice of intent if the work is outside of the buffer zone, or most of the work is outside?
We were conservative with our approach with you. We decided to go for a notice of intent just to make sure everything was kosher.
Okay.
And do everything we possibly could to be as transparent about what was going on as we could.
Okay. Thank you.
So I think, Chuck, when we talked about it, we said it could be an NDA, it could be an NOI, or whatever that other one is besides notice of intent. We went to the far side just to be safe.
Okay, so you're proposing stockade fencing too? That's
so
another activity.
The other change that I'm proposing, yes, good fences make good neighbors, is to put a fence up. I was supposed to have had an estimate by now, but unfortunately I do not.
Okay.
But I am proposing to put a fence up without taking down trees to do so, because in the conversation I had with Reliable Fencing, I just have to trim up some of the trees on the far side and then bring it around and down and over. If you have the current one, it will go right in front of or right behind, depending upon the feasibility of a rock wall at the back of my property, on the side of my property.
Gotcha.
And then it will come back up.
Stone wall.
To where the garage comes in.
And this is all existing lawn, right? Like you're not expanding the lawn.
I'm not expanding the lawn. It's all existing
lawn. Okay.
Exactly.
What kind of wildlife traffic do you get in your backyard?
Depends on the day. I haven't seen them in a long time, but I used to have deer and coyote, turkey. There used to be packs of 13 or 14 turkey that come through there. Rabbits, I have lots of rabbits.
Me too, in my vegetables.
Yeah. My wife is requesting that we don't do stockade, but do those narrow pillars ones. I don't know what those are called. But we're doing the fence for dogs,
picket.
So that's the reason why we're doing the fence.
Say that again?
Picket fence.
Picket fence.
Close to
picket
a picket.
Fence.
Just close enough so the small dog doesn't get through it, but wide enough so you can actually see something.
Now, the fence was not on the original.
The fence was not on the original. So that's
were these, are these stone walls existing, or were they proposed?
Stone walls are existing, sir.
And you're not going to change those, correct?
No, I'm not.
I have a question, though.
Yes, ma'am.
In this area down here, there seems that there's a stone wall here, running down here.
Yeah.
There's a break, okay.
Yeah.
Now, there's another stone wall. This, it looks like your fence is on the wetland side, then all of a sudden you cross over the stone wall. How are you gonna do that?
The wetland side, so,
so
when I talk to the fencing people, they have the ability to rise it up and bring it back down. But it's entirely possible that I may bring it in front of the stone instead of going behind, depending on what needs to happen with that. This was a rough estimate by the survey person to put a fence in so we could have the conversation.
Becky, if you look at the grades, it's almost, is it retaining any, the stone wall?
The stone wall retains nothing. At that point in the back, it's flat. It's the only place where we have grade issues is on, I can't zoom in up here if you guys can help, if you can look up here.
Yeah.
Is on this side of the yard.
97.4.
We do have grade issue right there.
Yeah.
And that's, we're going to have to be creative with the fence in that space, but that's also why, what does not show on that plan, but that I have now finished as of this more as of this afternoon, is a retaining wall will probably have to go along right in there.
So the fencing at this point sort of goes up the backyard and then comes in at the driveway, the proposed driveway.
Yes, ma'am.
Do you propose, are you at a point where you can speak to any gates or that you're going to put in the fencing?
My plan is to have four gates, one on the front, and go back to the fence drawing. Sorry, I have too many pictures on my iPad here.
Sorry.
My plan is to have four gates, one where the old driveway that I'm no longer doing anymore is, on the front right of the house, which is the top left of the diagram.
Mm-hmm.
A big two-door gate in the back that will swing into the yard or out to the yard, and then one gate in the front with the new driveway.
So two front gates.
Two front gates.
Are you proposing any gates along the back?
Yes.
The southern property.
The part where there's currently a break in the rock wall is where I expected to put a double gate that opens up.
So that's three gates. You said you were thinking of four?
I was counting the double as two.
Okay.
Two.
Okay.
So it was the ZBA that made you eliminate that other driveway? Or
so the ZBA did not. The ZBA approved my plan after changing the bylaw and all that kind of stuff. So I've really been through the ringer. Unfortunately, my neighbor appealed it, and it is under his view of it is that impacts his house too much. And he thinks that there were some questions about how the process of the driveway was approved. Rather than go through 2 years of zoning board related or superior court, I'm just saying I'll give that up.
Yeah.
Presuming I can get this, right? So I'm trying to get myself and the zoning board and the other people to settle and be done, and this is part of my proposal.
Just comment that third gate in the back between the break and rock wall.
Yes, ma'am.
Area. A number of times this has happened when I've gone on site visits, and a number of people, and I'm not insinuating that you fit into this category. I mean, you're obviously a careful person. I just raise it as a flag that, you know, for you to be aware of, is something that we watch for. Is sometimes, you know, with backyard fences, some property owners think to themselves, hey, I don't need to haul all this to the curb, all my yard waste and all this. You know, I got my back gate, that's all woods, let's just go dump it.
Mm-hmm.
And we've had a number of issues with that.
Okay.
With that. And, you know, some people think it's, you know, it's natural, you know, what's the problem? Well, maybe, you know, once in a lifetime, maybe that's not a problem. What happens is it becomes habitual for some people, and it becomes a large pile, suffocates roots, changes habitat. All of a sudden, all these trees in their back area,
yep.
All of a sudden people are coming to us saying, our trees are dying. Well, it's
okay.
Because the roots are getting suffocated from their own fill.
Okay.
You know, so I want to encourage you, that even though you have that back gate, and I'm sure you need it just to be able to go back there and check on things and see what's going on, you know, encourage you to, you know, to be a good steward of that land and not use it as a dumping ground, which is very, very tempting to do, especially because, you know,
yes.
nobody can see what you're doing back there. It's your own private land and,
yes.
you know, and all those, you know.
I appreciate
all
that
those
education.
Issues.
Right. In purpose of full disclosure, before all this was happening, that is what I do or what my lawn guy does.
Yeah.
So we can
yeah.
correct that problem.
Yeah. Okay.
Well,
I appreciate
it. Well, we would encourage
a compost
area. A compost area.
Yeah.
As long
sure.
as it's inside the resource area. And, you know, if it's, there's probably some space there inside the 100-foot buffer, but we would certainly encourage it for composting, or you can take it as tan composting, whichever.
Well, absolutely, composting. If people in town want to do their own composting and they set up a legitimate area and they keep track of it and they do
it
and they pen it in and you know,
sure.
yeah, that's great.
You also asked, do we need to update the silt fence to be outside the border of the new driveway? Well,
I believe we should, but that was.
Well, you're going to have to because you're going to put the driveway there.
Right.
So.
Yeah.
And then, do we need to move the silt fence outside the border of the planned fence? Is that where we put that, or would it suffice to be closer towards the building? What do we usually do?
Well, you're talking, in particular, we're talking about this area right here that currently is growing
yeah.
around and down here. So, where do we want to bring it? Now, one thing, and I can show you the diagram on my here, but I did not get it to Chuck in time, is that because of the grade from here to here, I have worked with an engineering firm to put a retaining wall there, because that will be about 5 to 6 feet between that space.
Drop
It'll
from
be a drop.
Off your driveway.
Yep. It currently goes as a hill down there. I probably have a picture on my phone that probably doesn't do justice. But so that's one thing I'm concerned about when it comes to the fence. My neighbor has said he did not write a letter in support because he didn't want to say it's a generic approval or anything like that. But we have had conversations throughout this whole legacy of process. He's been very supportive. He said whatever the town more or less agrees to on your property, I'll be happy to. If I need to ask him permission to put the fence in his yard to keep that control, I can ask him. I'm not sure that he'll say yes, but he's been overall supportive. But that's the caveat here is that this area here is likely to be where the retaining wall is, right up to the almost right up to the property line. So if you want to see what that currently is diagrammed as, I'm happy to pass this around because it would be part of the.
So truly, with this modification, the limit of work, if there's any erosion control, it is going to go off your property.
Most likely.
And at this point, at least the property to the east, you don't anticipate much disagreement with that property owner.
I do not.
Okay. Maybe to the west might be a different story.
The west, I mean,
thank you.
So if we're talking, yeah, this one is the one that's having the current problem and the reason why we're pulling the driveway on that side.
Right, but the fence goes.
The fence will be on the property line.
Right.
Right up
right.
the property line.
And
he has said he does not mind the fence. He said, do a fence. I just don't want a driveway right next to my property.
Right. Gotcha.
I'm going to step in while everyone's.
Go ahead.
Hey, Brian, can I get a question in while you guys are looking?
Yeah, go ahead.
I was just wondering if that driveway area, the proposed driveway, has to be that big.
So that was a question I asked the site plan / engineer that's working on the site plan. And he has a tool in his canopy or whatever in his belt to try it when he looks through these to see if the turn of a car will work properly.
Mm-hmm.
And I just said, is there any way we can tighten this up, or can we move the garage forward a little bit, or anything else along those lines, in order to get out of that 100 foot? Because if I can even get completely out of that, was what my thought was. And he said, if you want to save that tree in the front and not make it just a hugely wide driveway, then no, you don't really have an option. The width of this here, the way it is to enable a car to come and park like that, or a car to come and park like that, or a car to come and park like that. As it is, he was a little nervous about how wide this one is. Oops. But he had said in order for the cars to be able to come in and park, it needs to be as big as it is. I was trying to get it as small as I possibly could. Trying to save that tree as well. Technically, it's probably mine, but it's also right on south of Walnut, which is a scenic way, and other scenic way conversations would start to happen and things like that too. Ms. Longley, you were asking questions over there. Is there anything I can help with?
It's this tree that you're saving?
That front tree right there is a large maple-esque type tree that hangs over the driveway and the
maple-esque.
I don't know the right terminology of what it is, but I can show you a picture if you have the proper function of understanding that. Yes, sir.
What grade will the driveway be at, towards the south side of the wall? So,
at that point, it's more or less flat.
Okay.
The original drawing that she gave me today had the retaining wall going all the way up and all the way around, including all the way to the street. And up here, it's relatively flat. It's not a big problem. And back here, it's relatively flat. I had her come around the corner to reserve the corner, but this part is flat. I walk back here, no problem. Where I have a problem where the drop-off is almost where you see the silt fence down here. So these trees are right on a hill, and they drop right down to that area. But that back corner is not, on the top side of it is not a problem. On the bottom side is where we have the retaining.
Where you actually need the retaining wall.
Yes, sir.
I assume that your original driveway layout was to allow residents of this new addition to park close to their new addition.
Yes, sir.
And under the new layout, those residents will park on the other side of the lot.
On the new layout, the residents will park in this third bay, and they'll walk across the patio in the back to go into the...
Oh, that was my question. There is a patio they can walk across.
Yeah. There's a current patio that'll be rebuilt when all this is done, yes.
Okay.
In bad weather, they could walk through the house if necessary, but we could... They want to keep it as private as they want to, and we want to keep it private, so most of the time they'll walk out the back. I have the architecture drawings if you want to see
that. I'm good.
Any other?
So let me see, is this a minor change? Is that what we're looking at?
Yeah, we're wondering about a couple of things. I don't know what that's possible. So Tom's presenting a change that he hopes is a minor project change. You need to ask yourself, is this substantially change the project from what we originally agreed to? Or do abutters need to be notified of this change?
Well, I think in terms of resource area, it's still within, other than a small tiny portion, it's still within the 100 or 200 foot riparian zone. So, technically the changes are still within that same...
Tom did the calculation on imperviousness, and he's added some, but it's mostly in the outer 100. Mm-hmm. How much was that?
29 square feet.
29 square feet inside the 100-foot barrier or buffer zone. Mm-hmm. Yes.
There was some outside of it, too, so we've increased imperviousness.
Mm-hmm. Right.
700 square feet.
Yeah.
Total.
Additional.
So one of the other things that I talked to the original wetlands person that I worked with in this project, And he recommended that, just as we had promised we'd do in the driveway on the far side, that we put a stone trench around the outside. And you saw that in the diagram here from the retaining wall. So you will see that there will be a stone trench here to capture the water and then release it properly back in, as opposed to just letting it flow. If you didn't see that, I can show you this here as well.
So when,
where is it? Where is the
stone? So
the
best way to look at it,
on the bottom of the wall.
The best way to look at it is right here. That right there will be the stone trench. 18 inches deep, 12 inches wide.
It's at the bottom of the wall, right?
It's at the top.
It's at the top of the wall.
They've got weep holes at the bottom of the wall.
Yeah.
But so where does that go? I guess, where's that going to run after the trench? The grades are confusing me a little bit here, because we're cutting. But so the water's still going to flow behind there back into towards the backyard? I guess, where does that trench take the water?
That is a good question, and that's something I'm willing to stipulate here. I really don't know. If it means it should go toward the back, I'm sure I can have it graded and be, 18 down to 24 to get it go back. If it needs to go to the front, I can do that. If it needs to go out, I'll do what I need to do to make it compliant with what you guys would want it to do.
I think it should go where it's going now,
which is just down
the front. I think it's, so
it's just running into the next property.
Yes.
It's running into the next property.
So then the drawing here more or less allows for at the bottom of the retaining wall an outlet, as most retaining walls do. So it would probably filter down in there and then go out the outlet at the bottom of the retaining wall. If you see that right there, there's a
leak hole.
Yeah, exactly.
Is that adjacent property combination of manicured lawn and native vegetation?
In the grand scheme, yes. Yes, where it would go down into is manicured lawn.
That's even better.
Yeah, you can.
If you have it on Google, you can pull it up or I can show you.
This is the house, here's the neighbors.
Yeah, that's,
he's got quite a bit in between.
But it could be sloped to stay on your property and go into your own backyard.
That's what's necessary.
Could you pan back a little bit, Chuck, so I can see where that is in relation to Sturgis Park?
So here's Sturgis Park right here.
Across the street.
Here's the, these two spots here are the two ice rinks in the winter.
It's almost like there's a...
Yeah, if Sturgis is in the riverfront, it's hard to believe that is.
As well as it should, it's going to be out.
Yeah. I don't think you can get it any further into the backyard.
So if you zoom back in, this pool is no longer here. That's bad representation. This tree at the bottom of the hill, the neighbor would like to keep, and I will agree to keep that. That tree needs to stay. It's on his property. It will stay. But this here is manicured yard, and all of this is manicured yard. There's a playset back here, and then back here is where everything else happens, and that's not manicured yard.
Excuse me.
Go ahead. No, that's all right. Go ahead.
On the far right there, that building we see.
Isn't
that the one that's partially brick and he has the
hockey rink? This used to be the leach house.
When we did that, that was not riverfront.
Yeah, this used to be the leach
house. When we permitted that was not riverfront.
I just tried calling.
We could have been wrong, but...
When did you know?
Oh, 5-6 years ago. Not the building, the house, but he was doing a bunch of stuff back there.
It's all the same watershed. I'm not concerned. Whether it's coming from the left side of the house, from the old driveway, or it's coming from the right side of the house, it's all going to the same receiving area. So it's
on
a micro plan this.
Okay.
So.
Question, Chair.
Yes.
The tree that you pointed to, that's looks like it's kind of centered on the yellow line, at least from this picture, which may or may not be true. Is your proposed driveway going to interfere with that root zone?
I don't believe so, but I'm not an expert.
The
driveway itself will be at least 6 feet off of it. The retaining wall may come close, but I think it's far enough back. It's kind of a bad picture here, but they have a deck here now.
Mm-hmm.
And you look at the deck at our house and you see the tree, it's more right here. It's kind of weird the way that thing works, but we're actually, because the garage is here, the garage is gonna go from here to there. So it's really gonna be like the back corner of the driveway where that 100-foot buffer zone area is.
Right.
That's where that
gotcha.
Tree more or less is.
Okay.
And so working around that is important to me because I wanna make sure they're happy.
Okay. Yeah, because you don't wanna cut off that root zone and it'll damage the tree.
Yep.
There's a lot going on.
You're not kidding.
Even though it's a minor permit change.
How much time I spend in town hall working through some of these things.
I think it's more moving stuff around than anything.
You know, the biggest change I see is the addition of the fence, which is a barrier to wildlife. That said, what we've done in the past is has permitted fences within people's backyards, within their own backyards.
Street.
And,
Turn this way. Turn that way.
Keep
going.
Yeah,
other way.
Other way. Now go. Now this is the neighbor next door on the other side. That's my house right there.
Gotcha.
And that's the tree we're, no.
This is the tree that I'm saving as a result of this, as a compromise.
Yeah.
These two trees will be saved as well, and the driveway will curve up over.
Yeah.
Around
yeah.
that. Go one more thing down.
One more time.
There you go. Now turn right.
One more.
There you go.
Okay.
So you can sort of see the slope here a little bit. And this is where we take the driveway. Currently, it kind of comes up this way, like right there. We just take it out a little further and bring it back.
Do you have a sense of what equipment will be used to put up the fence? Is there going to be just machine augered posts?
Unfortunately, I have no idea. I'm not sure how.
They tend to hand auger more and more these days.
It's reliant.
So
if you know Reliance, that's who are planning to use. I'm not sure what they do.
Yeah. I'm just trying to get a sense of, I think with the fence in the back, I think some sort of, some thought about, I think silt fencing definitely needs to be in there to be between the resource area and the proposed addition and the driveway.
Yes.
And maybe the fencing's done last.
It's probably what's going to happen anyway. The fencing will be done last.
So that after the hay bale, I'm just thinking out loud, after the hay bale's taken up and then the go around and put the fence in.
Yeah, you don't need hay bales for fence.
Does that make sense from a construction sequence, Chuck?
I think there's an entire house and yard in front of this project between the stream. So, yeah, the erosion control should be put in, but it's more of a limit of work.
Right. Right. Yeah. Otherwise, I don't have any. I don't have any objection to making a minor change with the details here. How would, one thing that I would like to see would be the drainage off the driveway staying on your property. Good fences make good neighbors, and good drainage makes good neighbors too. So,
if I can do that.
Yeah, if it's possible.
This may be a stupid question, but I'm kind of ignorant in this regard. So can you back up a little bit? There is, over here in the street, there's a street drain. Would that be a place that's suitable to drain the water to or not?
Which water?
The water, the roof runoff water and the stone water and stuff like that.
That's an engineering question.
You don't mean a physical connection. You
no,
just want to just point
yeah, just
into that
in
direction.
Direction yeah.
From leaders? From your roof?
So
you
the
mean?
Roof leaders should probably go over the lawn
right.
or into the ground.
Okay.
Right, not to the storm drain.
But the paved area should be, if possible, without putting another 5 feet of wall in, should be pitched towards the catch basin, assuming you're not adding a Walmart parking lot there.
Yep.
That's generally the rule.
Okay.
Pavement into the catch basin and
roof
leaders into it, either on the lawn or into an infiltrator.
Okay.
So
I think we had originally proposed rain barrels in the first solution. we're perfectly okay doing the same if that's the proposal.
Those are good. Yeah, they work well as garden watering.
They're a little slow though.
Yeah, they are.
I'm trying to get it to work in the morning. Hurry up, fill up.
In writing up, how does this all get finalized and sort of codified going forward?
All of the other minor plan changes we've done, we've just accepted the documentation, and we're going to need some documentation to bring this along, but with a letter and just saying that we've made a vote at a meeting that we accept this. And
we have a new plan, so that'll be hard.
We'd like a stamped plan.
I have
and the up-to-date plans showing the retaining wall and everything we talked about tonight.
Yeah.
And with that and the letter, you know, be fine.
So does it go with the order of conditions in the official filing, or how does that work?
No, it's we just add it to the packet and note it that we've done a minor modification of the original order of conditions.
So the existing order of conditions is still the one that I'll file with the Middlesex County deeds and all that stuff when all this gets started.
Right. You have to get that recorded.
Yep.
And
so I move.
You could make. Since you haven't done that.
I have not done it because this project's been up in all sorts of things. So.
You should also record the minor modification letter and the new plans.
Okay.
I move we issue a minor plan change for something.
181.
181 South Street.
All those in favor?
Great.
That's it.
Good luck.
Thanks for your time and effort.
Thanks, Chuck. Appreciate it.
Chuck, you want to give us a rundown on 116 Van Norden?
Thank you very much.
Did everybody?
Thank you.
Have a good night.
Thank you. Did everybody? Everybody read, got the email and understood what happened with Van Norden?
I got the email. I still don't understand what happened.
I don't think anybody understands what happened.
What I know is that I was, contacted by the treasurer and
by
said,
who?
The treasurer.
The treasurer.
Yeah, Nancy Heffernan.
Yeah.
Town treasurer, and she said that the town owns this land, and from there, multiple conversations started with Gene and with Jesse, and I called Jack Sullivan, the engineer on this project, who said he didn't know anything about this, and by the end of the day, I received an email from Jack saying that they're withdrawing. Because that's the email I sent to you.
Did the town own it for back taxes? Do we
back
think?
Taxes is what it was taken for? Yeah.
All right then.
So this will be back before us then, because somebody's proposing to buy it and then develop it. So whether they buy it from an individual or the town, they could care less.
Right. Right. So we can take it up when it comes back.
At some point, it will be back.
Yep.
Right.
So that's off the schedule. So, while we're talking about that, are you ready to give an administrative report? Do you have any other items since we're on that?
No, that's all I was going to tell you about. If there were any questions, I could try to answer them. But basically, I just think that this is going to be resolved somehow, and we'll be back in front of us.
Okay, we'll deal with it then.
I do have some new business I'd like to bring up, if I could. Is this an appropriate time?
Sure.
I can wait.
Sure, yeah.
When we had that 3-inch, 2.5-inch rain on Thursday night,
was it that much?
Yeah, I had
really?
A rain gauge in my yard. It was about 2.5, between 2.5 and 3.
Really?
And I drove at the Willow Street, Summer Ave, West Street intersection. You know,
Willow Street. Yep.
Yeah.
Okay.
The staging area for
the staging
project.
Area,
okay.
And there
all
was about 4 or 5 inches of. I'd say mud. Somebody else might say dirty water, but I'd say mud that was standing there. And I'm sure it's found its way into the Arbogena River. I don't know why they don't have a permit for that staging area, because it's in the river zone, it's in the resource area, and there's zero silt fencing around there. There's an orange fence, so any silt particles bigger than that, it'll stop, but anything smaller is going right through there. we don't often get 3 inches, but when we do, it was a huge mess down there.
Is it still paved? I haven't been through there.
It's paved. Almost all of it's paved. So not the staging area.
Staging area isn't.
But they paved that summer ramp.
Well, because the staging area is not going to be paved. It's going to be.
It's going to be grass.
Right now, it's a mess.
Yeah.
I think they should put sill fencing around that that staging area. Because it's all torn up. There's equipment in and out all the time.
Right.
So that's my observation.
The storm drains around there do have silt sacks in them. We've been out there a couple of times. They may have been taken out, but I've been out there, and that's usually where we meet, and they've even put hay bale around that. That one right where the island is.
So you've seen that there is some addressing.
No, I've seen that that place turns into a mess when it rains.
It does.
Yeah.
And I've talked to them. Mm-hmm. We have a meeting every Thursday at 11 if anyone wants to show up. But, just to say these things, a lot of times there isn't anything to say, but I've talked at least twice, two other times about this one particular area.
Yeah.
Well, the water used to come down the hill and, collect at the bottom, and it was taking all the runoff and all the sediment down the hill. But I have also gone over the fence and looked down, and from what I've noticed, what that area looks like where the culverts come out and the spillway there, looks pretty much the same than it was before. So everything's flushing downstream.
Sending it to Winchester.
There's a lot of action there. There's a 36-inch pipe and a 20-inch
pipe. Yeah, we had a big bank erosion there a number of years ago, just on the downstream side of West Street.
Yeah, it's pretty steep. So, we're lucky to have on this particular project, Newport's very attentive to anything that engineering or myself says. So there's probably going to be some pushback to say, look, put silt fence around your staging area because then you've eliminated the exits.
Yeah. Right. No, yeah, we don't want to do that. But.
No, we want to protect where it might discharge.
Mm-hmm.
So if you've got a low area, maybe where the street comes around, there's the low area that kind of funnels the water in there. Put a couple of rows of silt fence and hay bales as check dams.
And they might need to clean up afterwards if we have a storm like 3 inches, because I'm sure there's a layer of street on the silt on the street after that water finally drained away.
So the policy that we came up with one of the first meetings is is it Friday? I don't remember if they work till, they must work on Friday. So at the end of the day on Friday, the street sweeper comes to town and does all that. But they may not be paying attention to this island area because they did ask them to do the streets.
The other thing they can do in that island area is trap rock. Just dump it right on there. It'll help a little bit with, the mass mud that comes out of there.
Mm-hmm. The velocity.
So you're going to have vehicles traveling in and out of there. If you put stone in there, like 6-inch minus, it's at least going to make it less muddy. And there'll be less sediment stirred up and washed out.
Yeah.
So.
All
right. I don't think they dumped any crushed stone or anything in that area.
They just drove right over the grass and everything else.
So Jamie, you saw the whole Abergona all muddied up.
Oh no, I didn't. It was raining too hard. I didn't get it.
You get it? Okay, so you don't
it
have
a
puddle
about this
come on.
Deep
yeah.
over that
no.
whole intersection.
Next time you need to go down into that river.
I just wanted to know. No, I know. I've been watching that too because I drive it pretty often. And
so that's good though. So it sounds like that they're attentive to what you're saying and what engineering's saying. That's
they
cool.
is. They are.
That's
is. Up the street from there, if I can add to this, there's a project there. There's a tree and an old stairs.
Is it Summer, Willow, where? What are you talking about?
It's West.
West.
Is West Street continuing on? Is that still West Street? Or is that Summer?
Going up past Long Meadow or whatever the name of that street is. Yeah, long.
So they had to remove some of the steps, and they were going to do some fill in that area and kind of make the whole front lawn. But that house is actually going to come to... That house is actually going to have a permit in front of us at some point, so they wanted to do minimal work. So we were all out there, waiting for some direction, and I haven't got any notification that the work's happened. So either they did it, without letting me know what the final outcome was, which was remove these two huge blocks and then fill in some area, or they're just gonna let it go for the next phase of the project. What they're trying to do is they're trying to make the sidewalk work around a tree and then where these steps are.
The town is. Oh, okay.
And this is on West Street?
Yeah.
On the east side of West Street?
Up the hill from where you're talking about.
But up the hill going toward Wilbur or going toward Wilmington?
Towards Wilmington.
Away from the project.
Away from the project, yeah.
Okay. Up the hill on your right-hand side?
Yes.
Catherine is the street there, if I remember correctly.
And it's the same resource area, right? Is it the other side of the river?
Yes, it's the other side of the river. What is this?
You should be able to log on as you at this terminal.
I don't want to. I wanted to get back to the main screen. I don't know what happened here.
Did you try 12345 as a password? Sorry.
Yeah, they come up with something pretty complicated. Well, I was going to show you where it is, but...
Anybody see that movie?
Well, anyways, that might be something where they're going to come in here and ask for a plan change also for this step and doing some work in front of the house.
Is that under the town-wide permit?
I assume
what
that they were within 5 feet of the road, you know, five, six, 7 feet.
Yeah.
I was gonna say that's part of the town project because
really
they had to
be.
Fix this area because of the town project.
We issued an individual permit for West Street.
Yes.
Yeah.
That would, and that's where they would do their minor change, and they were all gung-ho to do it, and then I have to say I didn't run into them. They didn't send it to me, so that could be coming up.
All right, so we'll see it when it gets in. Any other minor projects?
No.
No minor projects. Emergency permit.
There's none. Those are just placeholders if there is one.
Any bills?
There are no bills. Oh, and... But we will be getting bills because by the end of this month, Conservation Office is officially taking over Matera Cabin.
Oh. Okay.
So anybody who's going to get married or anything like that, we get a spot.
Ah, that sounds good.
I noticed Matera Cabin is still an entry and option on the rec department page. Is that going to move over?
We're
going to
always be there. We're just going to add a link to our page.
Good.
John's going to...
Yeah, I wouldn't move it if people are used to seeing it there. That's good.
Minutes for approval. 7:22, 20:15, and 8:12. Do we have changes?
Did we ever get 7:22? It's still not done.
No.
Okay. We do have 8:12. I saw that in the packet.
8:12 was... Yeah.
Do we have changes for that? Did people review it?
I reviewed it because I was curious what happened, and I noticed you didn't talk about Van Orden, so I wrote the question, and I got the answer. But anyway, when I read it, I assume it's correct, or I don't know if it's correct or not. But
what went out, the way you guys did it, what went out in the packet was what Michael's changes were and Anika's changes, because they sent them to me individually, and I sent the changes out in the packet.
I'm just looking at the description of RDA 2015 239 Main Street, and the next to the last sentence, I don't understand. The applicant has not discussed the project with the contractor, the extent the dumpster enclosed demolition.
Probably the extent of the dumpster.
Is that okay? Or if a foundation is needed to was known.
Or if it was known a foundation was needed.
Okay.
Yeah,
if we could just incorporate those minor edits.
I have a edit to the next sentence, and that is instead of a berm, just replace a berm with the word curbing.
Did you say a berm at the
meeting?
No. You
did. I did not.
Okay.
You discussed curbing.
Did you say a levee?
No. Canal. Barge fees.
Any other comments?
I had some minor editorial. Oh, sorry. This was actually a bigger question. Under minor projects, the first sentence, kind of a cliffhanger there at the end. RDAs for.
I don't have it in front of me. Yeah, read the whole sentence.
Brian Sullivan asked for input to add items to minor project list and review the RDAs for.
I don't know, you could just.
Input? What do you wanna?
You can strike that. You can strike after the ampersand.
Yeah, I will agree to striking after the ampersand.
Because I asked for minor project list.
Okay, so strike ampersand out.
Yes.
Okay, alright, I've got a couple.
I may have said something, but the gist of it was to add items to the minor project list.
I got a couple other real minor editorial. I'll just pass them down.
So I'll entertain a motion to accept the minutes as amended.
Second.
All those in favor? Okay.
I abstain, since we have enough to pass them and I wasn't there.
All those opposed, zero. Okay. Before we continue, Chuck, do you have anything else? Nothing else.
Nothing substantial. I can tell you that there's two members trying to get onto conservation.
I know there's one. I'm not aware of the second one.
Is there a second?
Second one just put in an application but couldn't make it to last night's meeting. So the vetting committee.
And we need, we're short two.
Who is it?
Oh, I don't have a name yet.
You don't know who it is?
No. Business person is what I heard.
Okay.
I was at that meeting.
Last
and,
night?
Yes, and they did not identify a separate applicant at that meeting.
For other committees,
they did identify applicants even though they weren't at the meeting to interview.
Mm-hmm.
So I guess they got their application too late to be on the agenda.
And also could not make it. So there was two things going on. She was asked if she could make it to last night's meeting. She said she couldn't, and the application came in yesterday or the day before. I'm not sure.
How did that go, last night's vetting meeting? Jamie, you want to give some feedback about that?
Selectman asked Al some questions. Al answered them. They voted in secret, but they did not vote last night.
Okay.
But they will make a vote. There are only two members on the subcommittee. I'm not sure.
I thought there were more than two. It was
the
subcommittee. No, I know what you're talking about, yeah.
And so they will, the subcommittee will make a recommendation to the full board of selectmen who will vote Tuesday night.
Can I ask who is on the subcommittee?
Kevin.
Are these selectmen?
Oh, yeah.
They're both selectmen.
John Halsey.
Okay. Yeah,
they're designated by the Board of Selectmen.
Right, as
screen.
A subcommittee.
Yeah.
Okay.
And oddly enough, the chair, Dan Ensinger, came in, so they were actually having a selectmen's meeting because they had a quorum there.
They had four?
They had three.
Three
only
is a
five
quorum?
Selectmen. So that was kind of odd.
That does sound odd. Did you get a sense of what type of questions did they ask? Did they ask his experience? Did they ask?
They asked his experience. They asked if he'd been to CONCOM meetings. They asked, there was some issue with the Planning Commission over it. What's his development over there off Van Norden?
Bethune. That's on Forest.
No, it's Sanborn.
I can't remember now which one it was. Anyway, there was some issue with the planning board that Selectman asked him about it, and he explained that I guess he'd gone before the planning board the night before and it was resolved. That's about it. 10 minutes? 15 minutes at most.
Okay.
So, has anybody given any thought to moving some of and you weren't here, so we asked last week, to start considering things that we can make as definitive minor projects and not RDAs. So, and we don't necessarily have to decide what they're going to be tonight, but has anybody
start
given any
discussion.
Thought to it?
I looked at some of this stuff. I think some of it, to me, is a little... I don't know.
Generic?
No, when I look at E, conversion of existing lawns to use as accessory to existing fence.
E, which?
This right.
This E, okay.
This E. I got this a while ago. So you want it outside the 50 feet, okay. And then it gives examples, and it says open slotted decks without roofs. But then I go on and look at porches under 100 square feet on existing foundations or on concrete footings. Then I look at sheds under 15 by 15, and everything else is like 100 square feet. It's like you're plopping a shed down, doesn't have foundation, but you're covering lawn, and now you want something under 100 feet, yet it's on foundations that aren't 100 feet. That doesn't make sense. Why are you plopping something 15 by 15 down where something else you're not? So, and what about the slotted, does that have a foundation? Do you, are you talking about something can't? So I was a little confused with some of these examples, if you know what I mean. They just
you're wondering what the message is behind all of it. What's the rule?
Yeah. And why are we, and then you can have an above ground pool any size. Doesn't make sense to me. It's not consistent. I guess that's my issue. But that's we, you know, I was talking to Chuck before you guys came in, and there was another thing that made sense to me. Allowing something that if it's on the front of a building and there's a whole building between it and your resource area,
yeah, right,
within that 50 feet, it's like, well, gee, why can't you allow that as a minor project?
So then maybe one minor project category could be a project undertaken within the buffer zone that has a significant barrier between the work, proposed work, and
mm-hmm.
and the resource area.
Yeah.
And still in the outer 50 feet or not?
I mean, that's a good question. Here's a for instance. Perfecto's Cafe is on the riverbank.
Right.
In the riverbank.
All right.
It is the riverbank.
So what if they wanted to put a planter on the front side of that building? They wanted to remove some of the parking lot, dig it down, put some loom in there on the front side of the building.
Haven't come to us.
Right, would that be an RDA or would that be
Is that an RDA? It's a minor project. And I'm not talking about removing the whole parking lot all the way up to the river. I'm saying you have a building between you and the resource area. Technically,
right.
The resource area.
But that falls under F, conversion of impervious surfaces to vegetated areas.
Assuming it doesn't fall under F. I'm just saying.
Okay. So it's like
an
a concrete, like a.
You know,
on a different helmet.
Example. Is that, I mean, would that be something that we would entertain because there's this barrier between the resource area? Technically, the riverfront is the resource area, but I'm just saying, you know, why should it matter, I guess, is what
well,
I'm saying.
Let's think about this. Why didn't you come up with an easy one? That's a hard question. Here's an easy one, though. In theory, there should be no structure within 25 feet of the river.
Right.
And any structure is going to be at least 25 feet wide. I mean, I'm sure there are exceptions, but in general. So if you're on the front, you're going to be 50 feet from the resource area in 99 out of 100 cases, I'll
right.
bet you.
And so I don't think we're going to come up with a situation where it's under that. But, I mean, I think it makes sense.
The goal of these is make it a little bit easier on Chuck. When
no, it's harder on Chuck.
On
it's
Chuck.
Easier on
well,
us.
Easier on us.
We don't care about Chuck.
Well, I think...
but they're
it's us we care about.
He knows whether to tell him, no, that you need to permit this or...
Well, he doesn't,
yeah,
he doesn't.
But
that's why
but
he's asking
be,
us.
There's got to be...
There's
got to
be clarity.
Yes.
There's got to be... Exactly.
There's
got
to be clarity in so that Chuck
instance,
can
we
see his
way
to go
to,
forward.
And to make it clear is to just add... projects. Just don't,
right.
Let's not rewrite it. Let's just say if you're 80 feet away working in front of a house, no matter what you're doing,
right.
either doesn't need a permit or it's definitely a minor project permit.
If it helps, we made a commitment to the Board of Selectmen and Town Meeting 6 years ago, 4 years ago to develop this list. And Bill Heck worked on it, and then that was the end of it. So this is consistent with our instructions to develop this list.
You developed the list, but I still have some issues with.
Oh no! Right.
I mean,
providing
it's not
a little background.
Yeah, it's just not
clear.
It's not clear.
Yeah.
Well, it's not consistent between
the different
different
items aspects that you're showing as examples.
Well, we talked about this at length, and we came up with two different approaches and never decided which one would be best. One would be to set some general guidelines, such as if you're in the outer buffer zone and you're not disturbing the ground surface, that's a minor project, no question.
50 to 100 foot.
And then similar general guidelines. The other basic approach is just as we think of them, or better yet, as people submit application, we just keep a list. And that list continues to grow. Or we could have a combination of those two things. But I think at a minimum, as we do issue minor projects, in sake of consistency, we add that project and equivalent to the list. So if somebody's neighbors comes in and says, well, I want a minor project because you gave next door neighbor a minor project, we say, yes, you're right.
So the performance standard is no significant adverse impact. So if we can say that a project is going to have no significant adverse impact on the resource area, then it should be a minor project because that's the performance standard. No significant potential adverse impact on a resource area.
Right.
So just keeping that in mind of when we're thinking of the projects that should be on this list, that's the standard.
Right.
So let me ask, what about the situation of somebody having a wintertime backyard rink? Is that a minor project?
Depends on where they are. If they're within 5 feet of the resource area, that's not a minor project.
But it's wintertime only.
Frozen
so
ground.
It's seasonal.
It's frozen ground.
I'm sorry, when that rink thaws, it's no longer winter. And they don't get that rink out of there until all the water's out of that rink. If it's too close, I don't think it's a minor project. Some of them might be. You know.
Are you digging into the ground to put a barrier to hold the water? Or?
Depends on the rink. I think some people can drive posts as wall support,
but I don't
because
think
there's walls, but there's no excavating.
I suppose you could.
No.
You could do anything.
No. Although, I have heard some people do a certain amount of leveling during the year to make sure when they put in their backyard
which
pool,
is a different thing
rink,
altogether.
Right, maybe a little spot leveling of their yard to make sure when their rink is put in.
So what distance would be good enough? Because usually you're staking something out to define the edge, and then you know you'll have some plywood or whatnot cut to size, and you nail that in, then you drape it with plastic. I mean that's your rank.
I'd be tempted to say on established lawn.
Use self leveling water. It's the best kind.
That's the best kind.
It'd be
yeah.
difficult putting
yeah.
it in the forest for sure.
Well, for people trying to fit
avoid
it in.
A lot of problems.
I've seen backyard abandoned for multiple seasons,
yeah.
if not years. Hockey rinks that have accumulated
mm-hmm.
sediment,
mm-hmm.
shopping carts, tires.
Oh.
And that sits there, and then you get a big rainstorm, and all that stuff washes right into the wetlands. If it's 50 feet away, it's probably something, it's probably not a big deal, but if it's close, it could be a big deal.
So it couldn't be any closer than 35 feet.
No, because then it's...
Yeah,
there's
something else.
It's
is it a structure?
Oh, yeah.
Temporary use?
Temporary,
is that a structure?
Temporary disturbance.
It
says structure. 35 feet is structure. No
yeah.
build zone.
Well,
no structure.
But a structure by our regulations is subsurface disturbance.
That's a slippery
so,
slope.
So that's... Me. Structure is something that interferes
slope.
With the root zone. By
correct.
Our bylaws.
And a foundation
so,
that would go in or one of those retaining walls would
you know,
be, and we've had that discussion.
In
right?
a lot of backyard rinks, it's a tarp, you know.
A lot are, a lot are.
Tarp with
25 feet away.
With wood,
then,
with wood framing.
Couldn't get any closer.
Laid on the ground itself.
And then if they don't take it out, that we don't have to address that with this part, but it could be an enforcement order. So, or maybe there could be a requirement that there's a spring site visit to make sure it's removed or picked
yes.
up or something.
Yes.
That's what I was gonna say. Have you ever had
I can
someone?
Think
we've
of
had,
two,
we've had at
two
least
or
two.
Three.
Yeah.
Two or three?
We've had at least
yeah.
two
I
rigs.
I can think of two definitely and probably a third.
I can think of a couple that haven't come to us but exist.
But they're not within resource area.
No, they're within resource
area. Not within resource area.
They're not.
But one of
they're at least within
one
river
of pretty, one
oh,
of
yeah.
pretty damn close.
Yeah. Oh, I guess you know that's the one.
So no, I just you know, something to discuss at some point.
I'm reluctant to have a blanket minor project anything within 50 feet. In general. There are exceptions. If it's a fence, maybe that'd be fine. But
did we
on the other hand, I think